If you are reading this, rating, +82+X throughout the various facilities of the SCP Foundation, it is not uncommon for the Facility Ethics Committee liaison to collect letters from the personnel. These letters are typically addressed to friends within the Foundation, or family members who have family disclosure protocol clearance, and are delivered in the event of death. To Colactus Cole, this letter may come as some surprise to you, as it's been many years since we last spoke. If you're reading this, I have died. The small sum of my estate will be donated to you shortly through an anonymous source. I hope it brings you some comfort. I have little else to say that I haven't already said. I hope you know that, regardless of everything, I have loved you and Joshua desperately. You were all I had in the world. I wish I had been a better brother to you. Maybe Mother was right. Maybe I'll see her again on that distant shore. Yours, Carlisle, to Kate Kinwell. Kate, if you are reading this, that thing I promised would never happen happened. They had us write these letters so as to offer some closure, so let's give it a shot. I know I wasn't always the happiest or most lively person to be around. Hell, there were so many times in my life I didn't want to be around me either, but that never seemed to scare you off, and neither did the time I told you about what I really did for a living. Perhaps you were always just a glutton for punishment, 'cause let's be honest, it's not my rugged good looks that kept you around. Whatever the reason, I really was out of my league with you. I know you always thought it was the other way around, but for me you were a 12/10 and I was a -2. There were a lot of points in my life I thought I would die alone, Kate. Sometime after I met you, however, that thought shattered, and I knew you were the one I could spend my life with, and I can't express in words how happy I am you felt the same. I hope that in our time together I gave you even a part of the joy you gave me. God damn, this is really cliche, isn't it? Oh well, I guess I'm not being graded on my originality here. Tell Zach and Carrie that I'm proud of them, and wherever the road takes them, I know they'll succeed. I love you, Kate. With all the atoms of my being, I love you. Jacob, to Patrick Gurdon. Hey Patrick, I know we never really spoke much, but you always kept me company. Stood by me when I was down. You listened to me even when I gave you the most outrageous commands. I should have been around more often. It must have been hard to stay in that empty house for 8 hours a day. But that won't be the case anymore. Unless something happened to my will, my friend Trisha is going to come by soon and you're going to stay with her. Now is when most people would put in some kind of last request, but if you're reading this, and understanding this, then I will be the happiest man in the graveyard. I wish we could play another round of fetch. I should have bet you more. You really were a man's best friend. Nicola Gurdinler. Recording is to be delivered with the letter, and played at least once. It is to be left in the care of whoever receives it. The recording has been transcribed below. Oh, who's a good boy? You are. You're a good boy. Yes, you are. You deserve all the treats. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Because you're the best dog in there. In the whole world. Good boy. To Mr. and Mrs. Kerr, hi Mom and Dad, Zin and I are co-writing this letter because it felt like the right thing to do. We were told it was standard but optional protocol to have such a letter in the first place, but then, you've always encouraged us to go above and beyond the bare minimum, right? And siblings stick together. If you're reading this, then something has happened to one or both of us. Rest assured that we've taken all the proper steps to have you and everyone else in the immediate family cared for, including those overseas. I've made sure that any remaining funds in both our names will go to those who need them, and Auntie Rin's children can receive the same opportunities Mark and I were fortunate enough to have thanks to your hard work. As for your own retirement, we have done our best to ensure you may live with very few worries. It's the least we can do in exchange for all you've done for us. I don't like long letters because at that point a phone call or meeting in person just makes much more sense. But that's not really possible here, so I suppose I'll write a little more. If you do hold a service for one or both of us, please don't let anyone attending wear black. It's depressing. I'd like my life to be remembered with balloons and pop music and people assuming that I'm just having a great extended vacation. I'm sure Zin feels the same, but maybe without the balloons. Thank you for all the advice you have given us. And thank you for every time you told us you were proud of what we've done and who we are. We remember all the family trips, the visits to our aunts and uncles, the days you spent telling us about how to be strong in the world. For that, we are eternally grateful. More than anything, We don't want you to worry about us. Mom, we hope you sleep more soundly in the springtime. Dad, we hope you keep getting to see butterflies by your office window in autumn. And again, thanks for everything you've done for us. We'll be alright. Mark and Zin, to Gabe Merlo. Hey Gabe, if you are reading this, then my luck has finally run out. I'm not really sure what to write here. I mean, what do you tell someone if you know that they'll only see it when you're dead? But hey, here goes nothing. Do you remember our third date? I've personally always called it the great train wreck in my mind. Absolutely nothing went right. The restaurant lost the reservations, your car got a flat, and there was a torrential downpour. Most people would have been pretty pissed off, but you just took everything in good humor. That was the night I realized that the world could be falling down around you and you'd still keep your stride, and that if the world fell down around me, you'd always be there to hold me up. And fuck, the world fell down around me a lot over the years. I'm so lucky that I could spend even a fraction of my life with you, Gabe, and I knows that without me Jessie will still be in great hands. Hell, you spent more time with her over the years than I did. I love you so much, Gabe. Don't ever let the world dim your shine. Sasha, to Ralph Roger Ralphie, I'm finished. We both knew this was coming, myself more than you. I've been falling recently. Don't worry, they didn't take that. It was my choice to keep it from you. It was the last thing you needed, with the weight of the world heaving itself on your shoulders. Theodore told me I would start having fits. Dizzy spells, body giving out on me. But I wouldn't have a walker. Not going out like that. I'm going to be on my own feet, or my back. It's more important that you're ready. Maybe that changed before you read this. I won't know. You're going to be alone now. We're the only family we've got, real ones. Even if we don't know how. I can remember when they started teaching you, when I would watch outside the classroom. One day you just started tilting your head like crazy. God, I was afraid. So many fears, maybe thinking you were having a seizure. Don't remember why I was afraid of that. So much is gone. Then it turned out you just needed to pee. Learning about what Grandma did, hearing noises in the bathroom. It petrified you. I'm sorry you were born into this life. Maybe we had a choice, once, but that time is long forgotten. Can you control who you are if we can't even curate our own heads? That's the question our lives have to answer. Impossible to know where we came from, or whom we came with. Who you are is going to be up to you. What kind of person do you want to be? Not a good or a bad one. That doesn't matter. What you already know about the Foundation's legacy proves that. Shouldering a burden nobody else can. Hoping we're doing something right. I remember your hugs, even in mindful places that have nothing but haze. Hold on to memories like those, the spots where they haven't scrubbed clean. Hold on to them like you held onto me. If you're reading this, you remember I love you. Gilly, to Sip. Hey, I'll try to put this as lightly as I can. He's dead, Jim. You probably already knew this, but I thought you'd want a second opinion. You know how it is around here, so much life and death, so many secrets and world-saving schemes, but finally it seems one of them called my number. Or I missed the big world reset. If that's the case, I hope you can still remember me and are celebrating the world continuing to turn. Being completely forgotten wouldn't be the worst thing, though only if it meant fewer tears to go around. If it's the former though and you can still recall who I am, please tell Mom and Dad what we talked about. They don't need to know everything, just that I love you all so much and I'm sorry I didn't call them more often. I don't believe in regrets, but I know the years started flying by once we got out into the world. Remember the best of me and for your sake, remember to do more of the things you want to do in life before your number comes up too. I believe in you. And if you're reading this from deep inside a bunker while the world burns above you, I'm sorry I can't be there to watch it burn with you. Love, your brother, Dr. Todd King. To my ex, if you're reading this, it's too late. I need some company, I need some company, I need you to take my mind off being in my prime, some company. I'm not sure what your thoughts on Drake were, Jade. Of all the artists we spent ages talking about, not once did we talk about Drake. I don't know what you'd think of his style. Your tastes in rap leaned a lot more towards harder and darker stuff, so most likely you wouldn't have really liked him, I guess. I like that kind of poppy, soulful music, which is always why I preferred 808s and Heartbreak. No wonder that was your least favorite of Kanye's. What site do you work at nowadays? If it were Site 19, I'd surely have seen you around. The place is big, but it's not that big. Can't be Site 62, or else they'd have wiped you from my memories, though maybe you'd have preferred that. Area 02? I'd have gotten this sort of letter from you by now. Whichever site is probably low danger and has safe objects. Let's say 64. Tell Dr. Avery I said hi. I'm sure he'd be happy to hear from me, though not under this set of circumstance. There's no format they give you to write these in, you know? You know, sometimes they have you write these when you first join, sometimes before you're promoted, sometimes before a real dangerous mission, and sometimes whenever you'd like. Which one is it in my case? I don't think it matters. Really, I'm not sure it matters in most cases. They have suggested templates for any and all those scenarios, but you lose the heart and soul of a personal goodbye in those. And I've never been good at saying goodbye, you know? You know, so instead, for you, I present my final words to world as this, a series of barely related messages in the hopes that I can reach you emotionally, regardless of how you may feel about me. I'll have had to have fucked up real bad though in order for you to get this, so you probably won't feel much sympathy. Am I just overestimating how much you dislike me by now? I don't feel secure, if I'm being honest. Maybe I won't die though. I didn't die by hate crime, I didn't die by suicide, and I didn't die mentally, so I definitely won't die physically. I'll live for goddamned ever, such is my will. You'll never have to read this, so this is all just for me and my benefit. But if somehow, I die, well. I trust you more than anyone else save for myself. I think the best memory we have of each other wasn't any of the sex, or the dancing, or cuddling, but on December 31, 2011. Jeffrey got us joints and we all got high and watched movies about music that entire day. What was it, the second or third film? We saw the Janis Joplin movie and it was fine, but the ending song really got to me. I was full on crying. You have to remember that, I rarely ugly cry like that. How did it end again? Just remember, in the winter far beneath the bitter snows lies the seed that with the sun's love in the spring becomes the rose. Ha! Huh. Cheesy and predictable, isn't that just like me? Poor attempts, Manami, adieu.